Have a good day. Let's say you are new to astrophotography and you want to capture the heavens, but you don't quite know how to. Maybe you are not sure what equipment you would need. There's too much information out there and it can be overwhelming. So today I will break down in simple language what you will need to begin your astrophotography journey. Well, three things: camera, tracker, and processing. Let's talk about the camera first. The best camera for astrophotography is whatever you have available. Almost any DSLR you've got will work. Some will do better, some will do worse, but they will work. But let's say you don't have any camera, what should you be looking for? Camera with the biggest pixel area you can get your hands on. Let's compare my nice sleek Canon M50 and good old 1100D. Now you would think that M50, because it's recent, it can record 4K, it's 24 megapixels and has all kinds of amazing capabilities, it will be better for deep sky astrophotography. Wrong. Actually, my Canon M50 sucks in comparison to the 1100D when it comes to deep sky astrophotography. Why? Well, my old camera has got 95% larger pixel area than M50. M50 might be good for wider astrophotography, like capturing the Milky Way, but for deep sky objects, the bigger the pixel area, the better. I'll recommend getting 450D or 1100D if you're interested in deep sky. These bodies are available for about $100 Australian dollars from Facebook Marketplace. As for the lenses, I would recommend starting out with your kit lens. You can upgrade when time comes, but kit lenses are generally good to begin with. Well, let's move on to our second ingredient, a tracker. As you know, the Earth rotates, and to compensate for it, you will need a tracker. There are many trackers available in the market: Sky Adventurer, iOptron, MSM, and so on. Which tracker should you go for? Well, I think only you can answer this question, because it depends on the kind of photography you will be doing. If you're primarily interested in wide Milky Way astrophotography, you should go for a portable MSM. If you're interested in both Milky Way astrophotography as well as large deep sky objects, go for Sky Adventurer 2i or iOptron, because they can handle the weight of a telephoto lens or a small refractor. Sky Adventurer is cheaper than iOptron, so I would go for them. Make sure you have a stable tripod for your tracker. Finally, let's talk about processing. Taking amazing photos is only half of the job done. You need to process these photos, and it will involve stacking, stretching, and sharpening. I've got a few videos on processing in Cyril, check that out. Processing can be tough to begin with, but I promise you, it gets very easy with time. So to summarize, you don't have to spend an astronomical amount of money to get great astro photos. You need a camera with a decent pixel area. You need a reasonably good tracker. You need some processing skills, and you are set to begin this amazing journey. I hope you found this helpful. If so, please subscribe. And if you have any questions, please write them in the comments below.